Today we're going fishing. Fishing for information. Information about what? Tilapia. That's a fish that is becoming more and more popular, and there are all kinds of headlines about it. Like this one, that it is worse for you than eating bacon. Well, let's look behind that headline. Where is this coming from? It's coming from a study that actually looked at the fat composition of tilapia and looked at the relative amount of the two kinds of fats that are important in our diet, the so-called omega-3 fats and the omega-6 fats. Well, before we get into that, I want to tell you about what that terminology means, because we are seeing that more and more often, especially in the lay literature. And in chemistry, we like to use models to describe molecules. This would be a molecule of what we call a fatty acid, and it contains a chain of carbon atoms, usually much longer than this one. If there is a double bond on the third carbon, 1, 2, 3, on the third carbon from the end of the molecule, we call it an omega-3 fat. If the double bond is on the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6th carbon from the end, we call it an omega-6 fat. Now, the omega-3s are the ones that we find in fish. And tuna, for example, would be a great example. It is very, very rich in omega-3 fats. These omega-3 fats are protective in terms of risk factors for heart disease. If someone has high triglycerides, high cholesterol, possibility for cardiac arrhythmia, these are protective. Now, on the other hand, the omega-6 fats, according to some studies, have inflammatory properties. And that is not a good thing, to cause inflammation in the body. And therefore, the thinking is that the better the ratio of the omega-3s to the omega-6s, the healthier that product is. Well, it turns out that when you look at tilapia, which is now a very, very popular fish, there's relatively little omega-3 to the omega-6. The reason for that is because of what the fish are fed. In the wild, fish eat algae, and that's where the omega-3 comes from. When they are raised on fish farms, as tilapia is, they're fed corn, they're fed soybeans. Those are very rich in the omega-6. So indeed, the ratio is not quite as good. That is what prompted the silly headline about bacon being better, because when you look at the fat composition of bacon, there is actually relatively better ratio of the omega-6 to the omega-3. This is totally irrelevant, because the omega-6 fats, aside from playing a role in this ratio, have been independently shown to reduce the risk of heart disease by reducing the so-called bad cholesterol, or LDL. So this business is just silly to have this headline with bacon. Bacon is full of saturated fat, and we know that that is not good for us. So it's taking a smidgen of information just out of context and making a big deal of it. No. Tilapia is not going to poison you, because it has less omega-3 fats than tuna or salmon, and it has more of the so-called pro-inflammatory omega-6s. This makes really no difference in the context of the overall diet. And also some stories about tilapia being fed manure, and that actually does happen sometimes in Asia, particularly in China. Tilapia will eat almost anything, and they can be fed pig manure and poultry manure. I mean, that's an unethical thing to do. Shouldn't be done, but unfortunately, sometimes it happens. It doesn't happen on fish farms that are in North America. So when there's a chance to make a selection of fish to eat, it is better to choose tilapia that was produced in North America than was used in Asia. But as far as this kind of headline goes, this is just nonsense. Any kind of fish, including tilapia, is better for us than bacon. But indeed, tuna or salmon would contain relatively more of the beneficial omega-3 fats. Unfortunately, I can only talk about this in theory. I can't eat fish. I have an allergy to it. The only way that I can handle fish is by playing with this kind. But if it were possible to eat fish, I certainly would do it, although not this particular one.